Boxing sensation, boxing star Chris Arreola, you just said you're fighting Seth Mitchell. If you don't win, you're retiring.
Absolutely.
You're going for the win.
Seth Mitchell doesn't belong in the ring with me, man, plain and simple. And honestly, I'm not a guy that you use to patent your record. I don't ever want to be that guy. I don't ever want to be the gatekeeper. That's not me. Like I said before, if you're not in boxing to be a world champion, then get the fuck out of boxing. I'm not in boxing to get a paycheck. I don't need a paycheck that bad. I want to be a world champion. That's why I'm in boxing.
What do you think about Deontay Wilder? 29-0, 29 knockouts?
Yeah, it's pretty good. You know, a couple cap fighters in between, but hey, it's all right. Whatever gets you the wins.
So you're going to be on Showtime. You're going to start in just a couple days. How was camp in Arizona?
Camp in Arizona is a mother, man.
Why? Hello.
Hello. It's hot. Hotter than shit. And I actually had to be at the gym every day, so that really sucked.
But Henry said he felt like a celebrity over there.
Henry a celebrity? Nah. Far from it. Hey guys.
So last question. September 14, Mayweather, Canelo, Matiz Garcia. Those two predictions.
Garcia, Mayweather.
Knockouts or decisions?
Decisions.
Hey, look who's here. We just talked about him and look. Henry, Chris, I told Chris you were like a celebrity. You were like a celebrity in Arizona, and he said no, he wasn't.
Nah, man, Arizona was good.
Why did you like it?
I mean, I never had to wonder if he was going to show up to the gym. No, like I said, we got him away from home. The camp it served its purpose. You know, now you just got to go out there and perform. Arizona heat, bro. We were there in the hottest part of the year. We were there with 6 weeks there. I had Jonathan Arellano out there with us. Josecito was out there with us before he got injured. But we're all under one roof. It's a lot different. We're at home. You're there at the gym waiting on Chris. Sometimes wondering if he's going to show up. Whereas here, we all drove to the gym together. Did the conditioning evening. So it was just
basic training.
Yeah. So it was good though.
And what do you think about the fight itself? Seth Mitchell, Chris Arreola. Chris just told me if he loses, he's retiring.
Look, I mean, you know what? I would probably encourage it, to be honest. I just don't see Seth as one of those upper echelon heavyweights, I'm being honest. You know, not to be disrespectful, but just an opinion. I think it's a fight where Chris is definitely going to look good in. You know, Mitchell's coming off a win. You know, not the most entertaining win, but he did avenge a loss, so I mean, the man deserves credit for that. You know, he comes from an athletic background, you know, he punched a little bit, but no way should a guy who just started boxing 6-7 years ago when, you know, we were fighting Malcolm Tan or Damian Mills, no way should a guy like that be able to beat Chris, no way in hell.
You go through this weekend, everything goes as planned. I know you're going to Vegas for September 14. I know they upgraded you at the NBA. Why did they upgrade you? Are you that big of a celebrity?
No. You know what it was, man? I booked my room like an hour after they announced the fight.
May 26th is when they announced it.
Not knowing if I would have anybody on the card. Didn't care. Okay. I booked the room because I knew the prices were going to be ridiculous. A couple of weeks ago, I called about an upgrade. And they said they were unavailable. I said, okay, well, if something comes up, can you please let me know? Well, I got an email last week saying I could upgrade my room to a suite for $30 a night. I was like, what? I jumped on it.
So how many people are calling you? How many people want to crash at your room right now?
A few people, but I'm not letting anybody. I'm only letting one friend stay with me. I can't wait, man. It's going to be a great, great atmosphere. And I was there when De La Hoya fought Mayweather. The buzz going into that fight, obviously the fight wasn't the most entertaining, but the buzz in the casino was great. I'm just looking forward to have no one on the card, just have a good time in Vegas. You know, I'll be there for like 4 days.
Mayweather Canelo, who do you like?
Well, I mean, obviously, you know, I'm Mayweather, but, you know, I mean, Canelo's a young, hungry, you know, pretty damn talented kid. I give him a better chance than anybody. I mean, I don't think he's going to win, but I give him a better shot than most.
Matiz Garcia? Because, you know, Cito's right there with them.
You know, that's a hell of a fight, man, you know. I mean, you got a favor with DC, but I don't think enough people are, I mean, people think Garcia's got no shot. I don't think so. You know, I think he's got a real shot to win. Favor with DC, but it's kind of a pick-em fight, you know? It's a hell of a fight.
And Henry, last question. You're going to a big event. You're on Showtime. You're very relaxed. Chris is very relaxed. Is this how you guys are always are before big events, like just another day at the office?
Yeah, pretty much. I guess you don't really start feeling the nerves like the day of the fight, or like, you know, like how you're anxious to get over. This is the press conference, and they kind of get old, you know. I'm going to put on a good show, I trained hard, I'm going to give it my all. You know, same, everybody says the same shit. It's fucking boring.
There I don't you, like doing this. There you have it. Ramirez, look out for him. Stay tuned for EsNewsReporting.com. I'm going to take back reporting. And if you need a place to crash in Vegas for the fight,
don't hit me up.